Guyana. Guyana, officially the Cooperative Republic of Guyana, is a country on the northern mainland of South America. It is the only English-speaking country in South America, although the majority of the population speaks Guyanese Creole, an English-based Creole language, as a first language, and is culturally considered part of the Anglophone Caribbean sphere. In addition, it is one of the founding member countries of the Caribbean Community Organization, CARICOM, which is headquartered in Guyana's capital and largest city, Georgetown. In 2008, the country joined the Union of South American Nations as a founding member. Guyana is bordered by the Atlantic Ocean to the north, Brazil to the south and southwest, Venezuela to the west, and Suriname to the east. With an area of 215,000 square kilometers, 83,000 square miles, Guyana is the third smallest sovereign state on mainland South America after Uruguay and Suriname. The region is known as the Guianas, consists of the large shield landmass north of the Amazon River and east of the Orinoco River known as the Land of Many Waters. Major rivers in Guyana include the Essequibo, the Berbice, and the Demerara. Originally inhabited by many indigenous groups, Guyana was settled by the Dutch before coming under British control in the late 18th century. It was governed as British Guiana, with a mostly plantation-style economy until the 1950s. It gained independence in 1966 and officially became a republic within the Commonwealth of Nations in 1970. The legacy of British rule is reflected in the country's political administration and diverse population, which includes Indian, African, Amerindian, and multiracial groups. Etymology of Guyana. The name, Guyana, derives from Guiana, the original name for the region that formerly included Guyana, British Guiana, Suriname, Dutch Guiana, French Guiana, and parts of Colombia, Venezuela, and Brazil. According to the Oxford English Dictionary, Guyana comes from an indigenous Amerindian language and means land of many waters. History of Guyana. There are 9 indigenous tribes residing in Guyana: the YY, Makushi, Patamona, Locono, Kalina, Wapishana, Pemin, Akawayo, and Warao. Historically, the Locono and Kalina tribes dominated Guyana. Although Christopher Columbus was the first European to sight Guyana during his third voyage, in 1498, and Sir Walter Raleigh wrote an account in 1596, the Dutch were the first Europeans to establish colonies: Essequibo, 1616, Berbice, 1627, and Demerara, 1752. After the British assumed control in 1796, the Dutch formally ceded the area in 1814. In 1831, the 3 separate colonies became a single British colony known as British Guiana. Since its independence in 1824, Venezuela has claimed the area of land to the west of the Essequibo River. Simón Bolívar wrote to the British government warning against the Berbice and Demerara settlers settling on land which the Venezuelans, as assumed heirs of Spanish claims on the area dating to the 16th century, claimed was theirs. In 1899, an international tribunal ruled the land belonged to Great Britain. The British territorial claim stemmed from Dutch involvement and colonization of the area, also dating to the 16th century, which was ceded to the British. Guyana achieved independence from the United Kingdom as a dominion on the 26th of May 1966 and became a republic on the 23rd of February 1970, remaining a member of the Commonwealth. The U.S. State Department and the U.S. Central Intelligence Agency, CIA, along with the British government, played a strong role in influencing political control in Guyana during this time. The American government supported Forbes Burnham during the early years of independence because Chetty Jagan was identified as a Marxist. They provided secret financial support and political campaign advice to Burnham's People's National Congress, to the detriment of the Jagan-led People's Progressive Party, which was mostly supported by Guyanese of East Indian background. In 1974, the Guyana government leased 1,500 hectares, 3,800 acres, of land to People's Temple, an American new religious movement, led by Pastor Jim Jones. The settlement, informally called Jonestown, eventually grew to a population of about 1,000 people, mostly emigrated from the United States. In 1978, Guyana received worldwide attention when 909 people died in a mass murder-suicide in Jonestown by drinking cyanide-laced Flavor Aid. A day prior, U.S. Congressman Leo Ryan had visited and toured the settlement as part of an investigation. As he was preparing to leave at the Port Kaituma airstrip, a group of People's Temple members pulled up and opened fire on the visiting delegation, killing Ryan and four other people. In May 2008, President Barrett Jagdeo was a signatory to the UNASUR Constitutive Treaty of the Union of South American Nations. The Guyanese government officially ratified the treaty in 2010. Geography of Guyana. The territory controlled by Guyana lies between latitudes 1 degree and 9 degrees north, and longitudes 56 degrees and 62 degrees west, and one of the world's most sparsely populated countries. The country can be divided into five natural regions: a narrow and fertile marshy plain along the Atlantic coast, low coastal plain, where most of the population lives, a white sand belt more inland, hilly sand and clay region, containing most of Guyana's mineral deposits, the dense rainforests, forested highland region, in the southern part of the country, the drier savanna areas in the southwest, and the smallest interior lowlands, interior savanna, consisting mostly of mountains that gradually rise to the Brazilian border. Some of Guyana's highest mountains are Mount Iyengana, 2,042 meters or 6,699 feet, Monte Cabarai, 1,465 meters or 4,806 feet, and Mount Roraima, 2,772 meters or 9,094 feet, the highest mountain in Guyana on the Brazil-Guyana-Venezuela tripoint border, part of the Pacaraima Range. Mount Roraima and Guyana's tabletop mountains, Tepes, are said to have been the inspiration for Sir Arthur Conan Doyle's 1912 novel The Lost World. There are also many volcanic escarpments and waterfalls, including Kaitor Falls, which is believed to be the largest single-drop waterfall in the world. North of the Rupununi River lies the Rupununi Savannah, south of which lie the Kanuku Mountains. The four longest rivers are the Essequibo at 1,010 kilometers, 628 miles long, the Corentyne River at 724 kilometers, 450 miles, the Berbice at 595 kilometers, 370 miles, and the Demerara at 346 kilometers, 215 miles. The Corentyne River forms the border with Suriname. At the mouth of the Essequibo are several large islands, including the 145 kilometers, 90 miles, wide shell beach along the northwest coast, which is also a major breeding area for sea turtles, mainly leatherbacks, and other wildlife. The local climate is tropical and generally hot and humid, though moderated by northeast trade winds along the coast. There are two rainy seasons, the first from May to mid-August, and the second from mid-November to mid-January. Guyana has one of the largest unspoiled rainforests in South America, some parts of which are almost inaccessible by humans. The rich natural history of Guyana was described by early explorers Sir Walter Raleigh and Charles Waterton and later by naturalists Sir David Attenborough and Gerald Durrell. In 2008, the BBC broadcast a three-part program called Lost Land of the Jaguar, which highlighted the huge diversity of wildlife, including undiscovered species and rare species such as the giant otter and harpy eagle. In 2012, Guyana received a $45 million reward from Norway for its rainforest protection efforts. This stems from a 2009 agreement between the nations for a total of $250 million for protecting and maintaining the natural habitat. Thus far, the country has received $115 million of the total grant. Economy of Guyana. The main economic activities in Guyana are agriculture, production of rice and demerara sugar, bauxite and gold mining, timber, shrimp fishing, and minerals. The sugar industry, which accounts for 28% of all export earnings, is largely run by the company Gaisu Co., which employs more people than any other industry. Many industries have a large foreign investment. For example, the American company Reynolds Metals and the British-Australian Rio Tinto's Rio Tinto Alcan subsidiary are heavily invested in Guyana's mineral industry. The Korean-Malaysian Barama company has a large stake in the logging industry. Since 2015, foreign companies have made several significant deepwater oil discoveries. Chronic problems include a shortage of skilled labor, deficient infrastructure, and until recently, sizable external debt. Low prices for key mining and agricultural commodities, combined with troubles in the bauxite and sugar industries, had threatened the government's tenuous fiscal position and dimmed prospects for the future. However, the Guyanese economy has rebounded slightly and exhibited moderate economic growth since 1999, thanks to an expansion in the agricultural and mining sectors, a more favorable atmosphere for business initiatives, a more realistic exchange rate, fairly low inflation, and the continued support of international organizations. In 2008, the economy witnessed a 3% increase in growth amid the global economic crisis. It grew by 5.4% in 2011 and 3.7% in 2012. Economic growth is expected to increase in 2020 following the completion of the first offshore oil project to 53% by IMF projections, the highest rate ever forecasted. GDP 2019 estimate $4.121 billion, $5,252 per capita. GDP growth rate 86.7%, 2020, inflation 12.3%, unemployment 11.0%, 2007. Languages of Guyana. English is the official language of Guyana and is used for education, government, media, and services. The vast majority of the population speaks Guyanese Creole, an English-based Creole with slight African and East Indian influence, as their native tongue. In addition, Cariban languages, Akawayo, YY, and Makushi, are spoken by a small minority, while Indic languages are retained for cultural and religious reasons. Government and politics. The politics of Guyana takes place in a framework of a presidential representative democratic republic, in which the president of Guyana is both head of state and head of government, and of a multi-party system. Executive power is exercised by the president and the government. Legislative power is vested in both the president and the National Assembly of Guyana. Historically, politics are a source of tension in the country, and violent riots have often broken out during elections. During the 1970s and 1980s, the political landscape was dominated by the People's National Congress. In 1992, the first constitutional elections were overseen by former United States President Jimmy Carter, and the People's Progressive Party led the country until 2015. The two parties are principally organized along ethnic lines and as a result, often clash on issues related to the allocation of resources. In the general elections held on 28 November 2011, the People's Progressive Party, PPP, retained a majority, and their presidential candidate Donald Ramatar was elected as president. On the 11th of May 2015, early general elections were held. A coalition of the A Partnership for National Unity Alliance for Change, APNUAFC, parties won 33 of the 65 seats in the National Assembly. On 16 May 2015, retired Army General David A. Granger became the 8th President of Guyana. However, on 21 December 2018, a vote of confidence was called for, regarding terms under which the government granted a franchise for offshore oil exploration. Legislator Charandas Prasad defected from the coalition and the vote failed, requiring new elections. The governing coalition litigated this result for the entire 90 days allowed for new elections. Military of Guyana. The Guyana Defense Force, GDF, is the military service of Guyana. The GDF was formed on 1 November 1965. Members of the new Defense Force were drawn from the British Guiana Volunteer Force, BGVF, Special Service Unit, SSU, British Guiana Police Force, BGPF, and civilians. Training assistance was provided by British instructors. In January 1969, the GDF faced their first test when the Rupununi Uprising, a bloody separatist movement in southern Guyana, attempted to annex the territory to Venezuela that was contained 3 days later with a balance of between 70 and 100 dead. The GDF is an integral part of the Guyanese nation. Resources and equipment of the GDF are used to help other Guyanese. Examples include medical mercy flights and the construction of roads and airstrips by the Engineering Corps. Education in Guyana. Guyana lacks a critical mass of expertise in many of the disciplines and activities on which it depends. At 88.5%, Guyana's literacy rate is the lowest in South America. The educational system does not sufficiently focus on the training of Guyanese in science and technology, technical and vocational subjects, business management, or computer sciences. The Guyanese education system is modeled on the former British education system. Students are expected to take the NGSA National Grade 6 assessment for entrance into high school in grade 7. They take the CXC at the end of high school. Schools have introduced the CAPE exams, which all other Caribbean countries have introduced. The A-level system, inherited from the British era, is offered only in a few schools. Sports in Guyana. The major sports in Guyana are cricket, Guyana as part of the West Indies as defined for international cricket purposes, basketball, football, and volleyball. Minor sports include softball cricket, beach cricket, field hockey, netball, rounders, lawn tennis, table tennis, boxing, squash, rugby, horse racing and a few others. Guyana played host to international cricket matches as part of the 2007 Cricket World Cup, CWC 2007. The new 15,000-seat Providence Stadium, also referred to as Guyana National Stadium, was built in time for the World Cup and was ready for the beginning of play on 28 March. At the first international game of CWC 2007 at the stadium, Lasith Malinga of the Sri Lankan team took 4 wickets in 4 consecutive deliveries. For international football purposes, Guyana is part of CONCACAF. The highest league in their club system is the GFF Elite League. Guyana also has 5 courses for horse racing. Thanks for watching this video. If you like this video, click on like button. If you want to watch more videos like this, click on the subscription button below. It's free subscription.